I have been to neurologist, physical therapy, brain scans, etc.
Girl, me too. I have an entire list of doctors and things I've tried. I brought up TOS to my neuro and ortho, anyone, and they all said no.
After months of watching YouTube vids, going to a chiropractor, and having acupuncture, this video alone has created such a sense of relief instantly.
Been to probably 10 chiropractors over 3 decades, and all are clueless. It's so frustrating trying to get professionals to actually diagnose you correctly and provide solutions. Any idea why so many with this condition are being failed by the medical community?
A matter of fact, I do have a few theories to why it takes so many doctors to find your thoracic outlet syndrome. And if you're in the same boat as these people, then make sure to stick around until the end to not only learn about the truth, but to also learn the best strategies for getting rid of your TOS. Adam here from TrainMassage.com. And being a sports massage therapist, I have worked with hundreds of people who have already tried working with their PTs and chiros with no success, but then spend only 1 hour on my table and will feel 10 times better. I'm not telling you all this to show off, even though it does make me look good. I'm telling you all this because after talking to all these different people, they all have very similar stories to how their PTs tried to treat them. Based on what everybody told me, the PTs only focus on exercising the stretched out muscles that feel tight, the acupuncturists only focus on sticking you with little knives, and the only thing chiros focus on is making your joints fart. Yes, you heard that right. Joint farters. Mm-hmm. And of course this makes sense, right? Because being a sports massage therapist, I usually focus on the tighter muscles that's creating your pain. And all this brings me to my first theory to why it takes so many doctors to find your TOS. It's simply because they're focusing on the wrong type of tightness. To understand this, you have to understand that there are two types of tightness a muscle can go through, and both of them can create two different types of pain. There's the tightness you feel in the upper back, which is usually the stretched out muscles, and then there's tightness you don't really feel in the front of the body, which shortens the muscle and can actually compress on nerves and blood vessels. Now, most PTs are only going to focus on strengthening those weaker muscles, the muscles that are stretched out and creating that tightness in your upper back and neck. And even though there's nothing wrong with this, which I'll get to later on, this isn't the right call if you want immediate relief from your thoracic outlet syndrome. The first place you're going to want to start is going to be in the front of the body, in the chest and shoulders, working on those shortened muscles. And here's why. Every single day, you are using the muscles in the front of the body, like the chest and the shoulders, to lift your arms up and perform your daily tasks. And even though these movements aren't technically making these muscles stronger, they are still making them shorter, which is going to be the key point. You see, if you even grew up just a little bit normal, not that person, then you probably lived your entire life with your arms out in front of you. From being in school for over 12 years, to working on a computer all day long, to driving to and from where you need to be, every single day you are using these muscles. And after years and years of doing this, the body's going to start remembering this pattern and start locking your muscles in this shortened position. But here's the kicker, right? When these muscles in the front of the body begin to shorten and tighten and stay that way, they will then begin to pull on the joint that they are attached to, which in turn begins to stretch out the muscles in the back, the ones that are chronically tight and stretched out. When one muscle shortens on one side, it pulls the joints it's attached to, which then makes the other muscles stretch out with it. And going back to those muscles in the front of the body, since they are becoming shortened and they're getting locked in that position, their range of motion is going to be limited and restricted, meaning the moment you even move your arm a little bit, that muscle's already at its full range of motion, which then makes it tight and create that compression on your nerves and blood vessels. And this is my first theory to why it takes so many doctors to find your TOS. It's because they're all focusing on the lengthened muscles instead of the shortened muscles, which I believe is not only creating your TOS and your neck pain, but can also create your bad posture, which is theory number two. You see, there are so many doctors out there that will try to tell you that your posture is not related to your pain. But here's why I believe they're wrong. If we go back to the muscle tightness, you're always going to notice a simple pattern how tight muscles shorten and tight muscles elongated are usually opposite of each other. And the reason for that is because that's how the body works and that's how your posture is created. But to help you understand this just a little more, let's change out the word posture for the word position. Thank you, Dr. Kelly Starrett, for this idea. Because you've been living in the same position for years and years on end, your posture or your body position is going to slowly begin to form into that shape. And as it begins to form this way, some muscles are naturally going to shorten while other muscles are naturally going to lengthen, which not only forms your posture over time, but also creates those different types of pain that we just talked about. On top of that, if you've already seen your PT for your shoulder pain, then there's a good chance they had you do things like external rotators, train the muscles in the upper back, or maybe even the deep cervical flexors with chin tucks. But have you ever asked yourself why they're doing this? It's not just because these muscles are weak. It's because when you strengthen a muscle, that muscle's naturally going to shorten, just like the muscles in the front. And what they're trying to do here is actually trying to shorten the muscles in the back in order to create tension on the joint, which then stretches out the front. Your PTs are literally trying to fix your posture without even realizing it. And of course, we can't talk about posture and pain without talking about the studies. Now, when it comes to studies, you're going to find some that show a direct relationship between bad posture and pain, and then you're going to find some that show no relationship between them. And my point here is not to tell you that your doctors are cherry picking some of the information. My point here is that studies are designed to give you a very specific answer to a very specific question, which is a good thing. But when it comes to your posture, there's just too many X factors within people's lives in order to make it accurate. For example, if you're trying to find a TOS and posture related connection, then you will have to look at things like, did they grow up playing sports or not? Because if they grew up playing sports, then they are naturally going to be strengthening the muscles in the back, shoulder, external rotators, all the things you'll do for physical therapy. Versus someone who played video games growing up, who had very little movement and very little activation in all those muscles besides the one they're using on a daily basis. You can also ask, are they a stomach sleeper or not? Because if you sleep on your stomach, chances are your head is rotated to the side for the entire night, which puts a key on your spine, and all this can create some sort of issues down the road, maybe some sort of TOS. You have to ask things like what's their daily job, because someone who works on a computer all day versus someone who works on lights all day is going to have two completely different problems or two completely different set of muscles that are strengthened but may still have something like forward head posture. And one more bonus point is, as I was doing some research for this video, I kept hearing a lot of doctors say the same repeated phrases over and over, which pretty much went along the lines of, not everybody who has bad posture has pain, and not everybody who has pain has bad posture, therefore they are not related. Well, not everybody who smokes cigarettes gets lung cancer, and not everybody who gets lung cancer smokes cigarettes. I don't think you're gonna find any damn doctors who are gonna argue against that unless they're working for big tobacco. You have to understand that your pain and your posture is not a direct relationship. It's more of a scale, basically, we'll call it. Just like how the more you smoke, the higher chance you have for lung cancer, the worse your posture is, the more of a chance you have for developing pain in the future. So the second reason I believe your doctor has trouble trying to find your TOS is because they're not taking your posture into consideration. Now, there is one more point I want to talk about, and that is your doctor is most likely a specialist. A physical therapist is a specialist in strengthening the muscles and helping mobility. An acupuncturist is a specialist in stabbing you with little knives in order to help you with your pain, which I believe is through the fascia system, but that's for another video. And joint farters release air from your joints, which is supposed to help you with your pain. Hell, even massage therapists are specialists on working on tight muscles. And you see, this is the problem. We are trying to attack your TOS pain and any other kind of shoulder pain for that matter by using only one to maybe two types of therapies at the same time. But here's the thing. There's no such thing as just weak muscles in the body. There's no such thing as just tight muscles in the body. And there's no such thing as a good chiro. Wait, what was I talking about? My point here is that the body is made up of multiple problems. Tight muscles, weak muscles, and maybe some joints not properly aligned. Which means, at least to me, that we should be trying to combine different treatments together in order to tackle all these issues creating your thoracic outlet syndrome. And of course, because nothing's ever that easy, I also do believe you have to do this in the correct order. Which is why it takes so many doctors to find your thoracic outlet syndrome. They focus on the wrong areas of the body, they won't take your posture into consideration, and they won't use any type of therapy that's outside their specialty. Now, I know what you're thinking. Are your doctors wrong then? No, they're not. I said your chiropractor, they're probably wrong. It simply means that they're coming in at the wrong time for your treatment. Remember how I said you have to go in the right order of therapies? Well, that's because you should be seeing different therapists at different times during your treatments. First off, start with a good sports massage therapist, because a good therapist is going to help you get rid of the knots and loosen the fascia around those muscles. This is important because it's this fascia that actually locks these muscles in this shortened and elongated positions. So by doing this first, it's going to make the next steps 10 times easier. The next step is for you to find someone who can stretch out those same muscles that you just massaged. Hopefully, your sports massage therapist can also do this. The idea here is now that the fascia system is loosened around the muscles, you can now stretch out that shortened muscle back to its original length. But remember to do this after you massage the fascia, otherwise you're going to be fighting a muscle that's locked in this position. And now that all the muscles are loosened and the shortened muscles are stretched out, you can go back to your physical therapist to do those exercises so that those lengthened muscles can now shorten. By saving this step for last, you're going to be able to strengthen those muscles without any tension in the front, which is going to make those exercises way more effective. PT and exercising in general is designed to keep your pain away, not take it away. But if you already have pain, then you need to first release and restore those tissues that are stuck, and then you need to retrain those muscles that are weak in order to keep that pain away. And a matter of fact, I actually teach you how to do this in my 21-day TOS challenge by using what I like to call the 3R system. The first R is release, and in this program, I'm gonna be showing you how to release all the shortened muscle that's creating not only your TOS, but also your forward head posture. We're then gonna move into the second stage, which is restore, where I'll be showing you how to stretch out all the muscles you just massaged and how to do some mobility drills to help realign those joints. And then the third R is retrain, where I'm gonna be showing you how to strengthen those weaker muscles in the back correctly in order to keep your pain away. And the best part is, if you don't get any results within 30 days, then you can ask for a refund and get all your money back. No questions asked. This means you can go through the entire program without any worries about getting ripped off. Go ahead and check out the 21-day TOS challenge by clicking on the link in the description below. Or if you need a little more convincing and you want to see this in action, then make sure to check out the video in the top right corner. I'll see you later.